night I have...
Listen to me, Mr.
Listen me, let me complete, then I have
a... I'm waiting for you to complete. Let me ask a question with your permission. My question to you is this, that consider the other politically volatile case of Balwant Singh Rajwana, who is accused of murdering Biyan Singh. Let us not forget, Mr. Grewal, that the Supreme Court itself said, I'm sorry to say directly to you, that the Rajwana clemency plea was a drama enacted by your government, by your chief minister.
No, it's a drama enacted by you, they said. No drama.
They said
no
it,
drama,
the court said
no
it.
No drama. We suffered loss of about 100 Akali leaders for the peace of Punjab. We don't want that any incident which happens in Delhi again disturbs the peace of Punjab.
What do you mean by putting that argument? You're putting out a threat?
No threat. Under the leadership of Sardar Prakash Singh Badal, Akali Dal fought for peace, communal harmony, and brotherhood amongst the communities. But unfortunately, the government, but the Congress government at 7 creates a situation for Punjab. To create problems for Akali.
Sir,
I don't want to.
Now, Mr. Grewal, you've taken a lot of time. I go to Manik Tegod. Mahesh Chetmalani, you want to counter him, but after that, Manik Tegod hasn't spoken yet. Manik Tegod is a member of parliament of the Congress party. Mr. Tegod, my question to you is this, that the lines between politics and the law of the land when it comes to death penalty are blurred. And hence, cases like Afzal Guru are subject to long delays and untenable excuses which fell flat when Guru was finally executed. All of these arguments fell flat. So how can you say that politics and law are not mixed in India? Do you actually believe?
Why? Please, Arnab.
Mr. Ghoni, let the Congress representative reply.
They stand separate only in the Constitution, not in actual use.
When a bench of Supreme Court stayed the execution of the...
Manik Tagore's turn, please. Manik Tagore. Manik Tagore, Member of Parliament of the Congress, is answering the question on politics and the law of the land.
Arnab, thank you. Thank you. One thing is that we need to accept the verdict of the court. And second very important thing is that doing politics with the verdict is not good. We are not good doing good to the country.
Who's doing politics?
Because the way every politician is doing, that's the problem. The politicians are doing it, that should not be done. Because when it's the lawmaker's work is to make a law, and the interpretation
Mr. Tagore,
is by the
just would like
system.
To take you back to
and
the Afzal Guru judgment. I would like to take you back to the clemency petition that was pending for years. We had a person who attacked the parliament, but you didn't prefer to decide his case. That's called politics. That's called politics interfering with the judicial system.
I had the patience to listen to you, and you should also have the patience to listen me. About the Afzal Guru, the decision has been taken, and what has happened, the history knows it, and you also knows it. Therefore, let us not go into a historical event. What I am saying is that when the justice systems make a decisions, let us not comment on it, and let us not do politics into it, and let us not put oil into the fire.
No, what
and
oil
the
into
regional
the fire?
Parties are oil doing into that emotional issue.
Mr. Manik Tagore,
which is going to,
Mr.
Which
Manik
is,
Tagore,
which is
nobody's
that.
Putting oil to the fire. I would like to remind you that between December 18, 2002 and May 2012, there are 16 reminders on Afzal Guru, which were sent by your Congress government to your Congress state government. Am I right or wrong? Who is doing politics, Mr. Manik Tagore? Accept that there is politics.
No. What I am saying is there should not be politics.
But there has been politics.
It's easier said than done.
There has been politics.
There should not be politics.
No,
that's
should
the,
not
what
be
I am
is,
saying is
no,
that legal system
be,
should take its own
should
course.
Should not be is an ideal world. There has been politics. You are accepting tonight on TV there has been politics.
we need to understand that there should not be politics into it, because it is a very, very different issue for a country of big like this size, where youngsters are having great voice in.
I have another question. No, I have another question, and here's an open challenge tonight to Aslam Goni, Mr. Grewal, and Mr. Manik Tagore, who are on the other side. Right? Open challenge here, right? Give me one case.
What is the open challenge? Please tell us what is the open challenge.
Thank you. Thank you. Now you see.
Tell me, do you disagree that there is no politics?
I haven't.
Arna, please kindly, do you disagree that there is no politics in these executions?
Of course there is. Your party has been doing politics over Muhammad Afzal. Over Afzal Guru.
I am out if you say there is no politics.
I am saying there is politics.
I am making you a judge tonight. I have always been telling you that don't judge things. I am making you a judge tonight. Tell me there is no politics in all these executions.
Mr. Aslam Goni, because you realized your argument is flawed, you are now trying to change your position. But I won't let you get away so easily.
No, please. I am telling you, I am making you judge. Arnab, I am making you judge.
I am no judge.
You tell me, is not there any politics in all these executions?
You take my challenge. Here's the question.
I have always been telling you don't judge the things. I am telling you tonight that you be the judge and tell.
Thank you for the offer. I am not qualified in law to even be a lawyer, leave alone a judge. Mahesh Jethmalani wants to come in at this stage. I allow Mahesh Jethmalani before I put my challenge in. Mahesh Jethmalani first. Yes, Mr. Jethmalani.
No. Arnab, just two very quick points. Salute the Supreme Court that it carved out an exception. It said delay does dehumanize the convict. It does. And it said that it can still be a factor to be taken into consideration, except in the case of terrorists. The Supreme Court implicitly recognized that in the case of terrorist convicts, there is this strong pressure, not only on moral grounds have they forfeited their rights to claim delay and therefore commutation, but there is the politics, and therefore the Supreme Court has risen above politics and said in the case of terrorists, because there is this kind of politics, they will not be allowed to raise this delay. What we should all be doing now is taking a cue from the Supreme Court. Instead of putting the burden on the Supreme Court every time a politician left out the country, what we should be doing, is saying that there must be a time limit. There's a self-imposed, the Supreme Court in Chasing case said there should be a self-imposed time limit by authorities for mercy petitions of 3 months. We should make sure as citizens that time limit is scrupulously adhered to. It becomes a norm in this country.
I'm sorry, Mr. Mahesh Jethmalani. It all sounds very good, doesn't it? This whole self-proclaimed tough stand on terror that you always take on television appears to be in 100% contradiction, Mr. Jethmalani, with that of your ally, the Shiromani Akali Dal. When you don't spare the Congress party or the so-called vote bank politics. You are a BJP person.
I'm not defending the Shiromani Akali Dal.
I am disagreeing openly
on television tonight.
I am telling you openly on television tonight. You don't spare the Congress for their so-called vote bank politics in the Afzal Guru case. Call a spade in the case of the Shiromani Akali Dal and their position on Bullar and Rajwana.
I am not sparing the Shiromani Akali Dal either. Where did you hear that? You are hearing things, Arnab.
I am not hearing things. I know that you've been soft on the Rajwana issue.
I am not defending the Shiromani Akali Dal.
Well,
why are you creating a straw argument just to make this debate a little more contentious?
No, I don't.
I am trying to rise above politics. You are getting into politics.
Really? Mr. Jethmalani, for all the criticism of the UPA government, will you concede tonight? Will you concede tonight? All right, to throw pot shots at me, will you concede tonight? Not a single decision was taken on mercy petitions during your NDA tenure. Have you not been asked that question in the floor of Parliament by the Home Minister, Mr. Chidambaram, when he was Home Minister?
Yes, and Arnab, if you know all this and still you don't believe that this
wrong.
Is politics. When you say
what I'm saying is you are right.
This is not all
any
politics.
Delay by the NDA government
all
in disposing
politics,
of mercy petitions should be condemned. What more do you want?
Should be condemned. I think that's extremely soft.
Signal.
Extremely
very wonderful
soft.
Signal you are sending to the rest of the world. That yes, you
what
have got
are you,
in
what,
front
what,
and
I, what more do you want me to say? You give me the words, you write my script, Arnab.
I am not interested in writing
the
script. I want the politicians to be honest tonight to agree that if you see the discourse among political parties in India on the death penalty, you will see it centers around cases like Afzal, Bullar, Rajwana and Rajiv Gandhi's assassins. You do not hear any political party in India talking about Ramji Chauhan or Jafar Ali. This goes on to prove that you are not guided by a principled position yes. against the death penalty, but purely by political
That's
considerations.
There is a judgment. There is a judgment, and this is what I wanted to convey to you.
Sudha Ramalingam wants to come in. Sudha Ramalingam.